Hello, Alina from XM8 Mastery here, and today I'd like to talk sketch shortcuts. So last week we talked about estimating shortcuts, some things that you can do when writing your estimates that will make your time easier. I've got a cat here. Just know that we've got friends in our office today that are having a great time. You'll probably hear her in the other video. She's being very vocal today. Anyhow, what I was trying to say was, just like my short hair, I can shorten your estimating time with these sketch shortcuts. So there's some commonly used ones that we'll go over, and some other ones that some restoration contractors that I've taught in the past have really appreciated. They've been using the software for like 10 years and didn't know this one shortcut. So stay tuned for that one. If you are a veteran, I do have some information for you as well. Me and Emmy, we're gonna get to work now and do some recording. So see you on the other side. Here I am in Xactimate. I'm of course in the sketch screen of an estimate, and we're going to go over some of the more commonly used shortcuts and then a few tricks that I've learned that are shortcuts over the years that you may not know about. So we'll take a look at this here. First of all, the most useful and easy to remember is R for room. So if you hover over each of these icons here at the top icon bar in Sketch or the toolbar, you will see that you can find the shortcut keys immediately by hovering. So of course we've got R for room. That's the easiest one to remember. R for room, that'll load a room to our cursor, and then we can just place one on our sketch screen. Sorry if you hear meowing in the background. My cat's having a fun day here in the office. Okay, so that's R for room. Quite simple and easy to remember, and was one of the first shortcuts that I learned. Now the next one to go over is for the roof. So that was one that I kept on pressing R for roof, which of course was bringing up a room and I would get frustrated. So what I would remember is F for what you don't want to do in life, which is fall off the roof. I have no idea why Xactware picked F for the shortcut for the roof, but that's the way that I have remembered it over the years. I don't want to fall off the roof, but I use F for my shortcut for the roof. So that's gonna be your shortcut for bringing that into your cursor. The other fun thing is if you hit your F key and then your roof is still in the ghost image or it's still attached to your cursor, you can hit your space bar to roll through the different types of roofs. So that's another shortcut if you're using a lot of different types of roofs out there, you're not using that straight gable all the time. Go ahead and hit your space bar and that will allow you to toggle through the different types of roofs. Also, if you don't like the way the ridge is oriented while it's in ghost image, you can always tab around. I think you've seen that in my videos. We can tab, we'll take you to the left. Shift tab will take you back counterclockwise? Gosh, I don't know. The other way. It'll take you back the other way. So tab will also rotate things, and it'll rotate other tools in Xactimate too if it's still loaded to the ghost image or loaded to your cursor here in the ghost image. So escape always clears your cursor. Sometimes you'll find that you have something stuck to your cursor that you don't know what it is. You accidentally click somewhere, or maybe you hit a shortcut you didn't need to. You'll have something stuck to your cursor. So escape will clear your cursor every time and take off whatever is attached in the ghost image. So, all right, we've already gone through quite a few. We've got R for room, F for roof, F in conjunction with the space bar will give you your different roof types. Tab will allow you to tab around and rotate the roof, and escape key is going to clear your cursor. So, whew, I already went through quite a few and it's just been about a minute here. The next one I want to talk about is the doors and windows. Those are quite easy as well. Again, if you hover, you can find these door and window quite easily. The D for door will allow that door to be adhered to my cursor, and if I hold down my control key, I can set doors all day long. So that's the shortcut there. I know that D is for doors, pretty intuitive, but if you hold down your control key, you can set multiple doors in the wall without having to hit D, set the door, hit D, set the door. You can just go ahead and hold that control key. Same with for the windows. So I can tap W on my keyboard and I can hold down my control key, then click. All right, so that's key there, if you will. Don't click first. You have to load the tool to your cursor, hold down the control key secondly, and then third, go ahead and click your heart's content, like so. So holding that control key will allow any thing that's loaded to your cursor to stay. Even with the room here, if I hold control, it'll set multiple rooms. So just remember that. Escape key clears my cursor, and now I can take a look and see what I can do with these windows. Now, when I set all the windows, there are 504s, I believe. If I go to the properties here, yep, those are 504s. So I want them to be 304s, meaning 3 foot wide, 4 foot tall. So I'm going to highlight by clicking the first window, holding down my control key, and clicking all the subsequent windows that I want to change. So I can highlight multiple using my control key and go to the properties and change all of those widths to 3 foot all at once. So I don't have to go around and click, click, click. The more clicks I can save you, the more time I'm saving here is what I'm trying to do. That's my goal. You can also set your deduct windows to yes this way. I've had quite a few restoration contractors that do rebuilds that they will have to go into each window or each door and click deduct yes because they forgot to turn that on, or their properties weren't set up correctly, or maybe they have to turn it to no when their properties are set to yes. So there's a couple variables there. But if you ever need to deduct or not deduct your windows and doors as a whole, remember the control key. It'll save you so much time. So I can go back in here with my doors and turn that to yes. Maybe I have to deduct the doors but not the windows. Who knows? We have crazy requirements from the insurance company sometimes, and we have to deduct the doors today. So use that control key to highlight multiple windows, multiple doors, and make your changes, and that'll save you quite a bit of time. Last but not least, we'll go over the square break tool. B for break on your keyboard. Square break does a lot of fun things, but I really love it on the roof. I can left click once with my square break tool, hold down my control key, hover over that handle, and left click hold and drag out roof extensions. This is the best way to create roof extensions because if I go and grab another roof here and put it on like so, you'll see it does a snub nose thing. It does a lot of weird things, but there is no part number. So see how roof 2 has that little in parentheses part number? That means it's a part of roof 1. Whatever I add to roof 2 is going to roll out into roof 1. If you go over to estimate items, you'll see this right here. Roof 1 includes roof 2 because it has a part number, because I use a square break tool. Roof 3 I pulled in independently, so it will not take on the shingles or any of the line items that I add to roof 1. It is a different entity. I can go and make it a part of, okay, I could go and make it a subgroup of roof 1, but it won't automatically do it, and it acts independently of the other roof planes. So I do not like going and taking another roof if possible and adding it on. Using that square break tool in conjunction with your control key is the best way to add the roof extension. So gosh, I packed a lot of information in this one. Hope I didn't overwhelm you guys out there, but okay, just to review, we've got R for room, F for roof, D for door, W for window, B for square break. Don't forget about your control keys and how they can control different aspects of the sketch. And also use that tab key to flip things around whenever you need to. Oh, and don't forget about the roof. If you want to scroll through the different roof types, load that roof to your cursor and hit that space bar, and that'll allow you to toggle through the different types of roofs. This has been Alina Wilson with XM8 Mastery. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please share if you find it useful. Also, like this video. It's like gold for my YouTube channel when you guys are liking my videos. Love it. You guys are awesome out there. And also subscribe for our weekly tips that we usually upload every Tuesday. Today is Thursday. I was a little late this week, but yeah, we try to get them out every Tuesday to you guys. For more information on XM8 Mastery and my training for restoration contractors, go visit my website at www.xm8mastery.com. Hope you guys are having a really great week. The season's getting started. Hopefully you guys are getting some storms out there. And we'll talk to you next week.